What's up, Soul Tribe? It's your girl Dominique with Empathic Guidance, and I'm back with another video for you guys today.
You say you got a girl.
All right, you guys. So I must say, I'm a little tired. So if my energy is a little lag, it's because I just got off of a long day at work and I couldn't take a break because one of my team members, the only team member that was here today, because both my supervisors had trainings today, and it was me and one other person, and she was on crutches, so I couldn't leave her side. So I'm extremely tired, hungry, haven't eaten, haven't taken a break, but you know, I'll be coming with my normal energy in the next video. But anyways, guys, so I have to share with you guys that I ran into I don't know, a really spiritually inclined, profound-minded young man on YouTube by the name of Enoch, Prince of Freestyle. And he has some interesting videos that I resonated very deeply with. And I'm definitely going to be binge-watching his videos. And I say you guys should too. So his name, again, is Enoch the Freestyle, the Prince of Freestyle. So, just speaking of the things that I was watching, it was just funny that he kind of went through my timeline or whatever, because I'm on YouTube or whatever, because I was just searching random videos and I ran across one of his videos, and then I ended up watching like five of them because he keep it short and sweet. But I resonated with a lot of stuff that he said, and I woke up sort of like with a downloaded message, and I share something on my Facebook page that has something to do with what I woke up having a download about. And it was about just being in support of other people. And if you guys notice, like, I frequently give other people shout outs because just simply because I really want to see other people doing good. Like, where is your heart if you don't want to see other people doing good? Like, I don't know, but I just had to reach out because I definitely noticed that, you know, I have a big following, but the people that's mainly, like, interacting with me is people that I don't know. So I'll be, like, wondering where my front center day ones are, you know, but so that's what this video is about, because I know a lot of you kind of are out here trying to do something good, raise awareness for something that you're passionate about or something that you've been through that you know other people are going through. You know, no matter how, like, fun and, like, the different topics and zodiac videos that I post, like, my aim for this channel and my aim of building this soul tribe and building this community of people is to basically help people that have been through similar situations. And even if their situation isn't, if they just, like, feel like a spiritual outcast, to just come here and have a family, somebody that can lean on, somebody that know and understand the things that they experienced and are going through. So that's why I created this channel, so that I can build this family up, build this soul tribe up to be each other's support system. And that's exactly what you guys have been. So I definitely have much amplified gratitude towards you guys for being such a rock, being in my corner during this journey. Like, you guys have been right there by my side from day one of these videos where I didn't know what to say, or I just still feel nervous, and sometimes I still do, especially when my throat chakra is blocked. But I definitely want to thank you, and I'm going to always keep thanking y'all, and I'm going to always, you know, shout out people that I feel like deserve more recognition than what they getting, because I know how it feels to, like, want to spread awareness and just ask for free support. Just click this button, just watch this video. Like, even if you washing dishes or cooking food, let it just play while you're doing that or whatever. And it's so hard for people to do that these days. And I was listening to a great spiritual speaker, and she told this wonderful story, and I'm gonna pass it on to you guys because I feel like it's very important for us to look at life like this when we go through our day to day, and the things that we think in our mind and the things that we allow out of our mouths, you know what I'm saying, and how that can have a boomerang effect on us. And we sitting up here wondering, like, I don't never do anything to anybody, you know, I'm a law-abiding citizen, I go to work every day, I work hard, why is life so hard for me? And it's because we don't realize that what we put out there, I mean, and a lot of us do, I'm not going to say nobody does, but a lot of us don't realize that our subconscious are the things that we just say, like, what did they do to deserve this? Or, you know, I'm not even going to support them because... You know, I never had nobody support. That's all the more reason for you to want to support somebody because you feel like you never had support. I'm always extending support because, like I said, it naturally feels good to see other people rising, especially when I've seen them start out and it's like, oh my God, look how far they came, you know, and a lot of people don't feel like that. And it just makes me wonder why. But I'm gonna get into the story that the spiritual healer told on her channel that I watched and want to pass on to you guys. So she said that this old man was walking for a very long time through the desert, and like a half a mile up, he spotted this huge tree that cast like so much shade. He was like, I am so hot and I'm so tired from walking so many miles. I need to get under this tree and take a nap. So, and that's exactly what he did. He got under the tree, you know, he laid out himself a pallet to take a nap, and he took a nap. And when he woke up, he was like, man, I'm kind of hungry now. I sure could use some food. And just like that, it's like a rollout table and a whole feast just rolled out right in front of him. He like, oh my God, start feasting on the food. He was like, oh my goodness, I don't know why I didn't think to ask for something to wash it down with. And just like that, another table appeared in front of him with all sort of different drinks for him to indulge in. He started sipping these drinks and thinking to himself, man, I didn't even ask where any of this came from. For all I know, it could be from demons. And then all of a sudden, demons appeared. And he's like, oh my God, demons, they're going to torture me. And they started to torture him. And he said, oh my God, I'm going to die. And he died. And what that man didn't realize was that that tree that he took a nap under was a wishing tree. And everything that he said or thought came into fruition just like that. And that's how you guys need to think about life when you're in this universal energy field. Like the things that you say negatively, you know, they affect someone, or they can affect you, because even if you subconsciously just wishing some bad on somebody, just having an envious moment about them, and it's like, maybe that's not really your heart. Maybe you really do have a good heart and you wondering why you having such a hard time in life, but you, instead of congratulating somebody, you think of reasons why you deserve it more than they do, or whatever the case may be, you know, but not being, you know, congratulating people when they get they just do. It's like that's sending not only negative energy to them, and, you know, it could possibly block them, especially if they don't have their space protected, if they don't have their energy protected. But it can also come back on you, because what you put out, you get back. So, I mean, I think people should start being more conscious of the things that they say and the things that they think, and, you know, naturally transform that. Because even if you're just being fake with it, I mean, it's not obvious to a human being, but it's, of course, going to be obvious to the Most High. you know. So, you know, try to transform your way of thinking to where you don't have those envious thoughts of people rising above you. Congratulate people and know that what's for you is going to be for you no matter what. And you just got to work hard towards it. But if somebody worked their fingers to the bone to get where they're at, then congratulate that person. And if you can, if it doesn't cost you anything, support that person, because you don't get that love and that support and that good energy that you're putting out, you're going to get back too. And you're going to see naturally that gifts and blessings start to come towards you when you offer gifts and blessings, even if it's just a verbal blessing like congratulations or I wish you the best. That's things that you would get in return, are probably things even better and more valuable than a verbal gratitude. So, you know, try to transform your way of thinking if that's something that you know, and you can silently notice. If you sitting here watching this with your friends, you don't have to admit, yeah, I ain't even gonna lie, girl. It was times that, yeah, when Tony proposed to you, I felt like, damn, I feel like I deserve a ring more than her. You know, you don't have to openly admit it. You know, admit it in your mind, like, dang, that's been me. Because I can honestly say that's been me. And I was wondering why my life was a shit show. And it was because I wasn't wishing the best on other people. And in turn, I was getting that energy back. And I worked on transforming my way of thinking and my way of feeling when it comes to things like that. And just opening up my heart space to not think on an envious level or a jealous level. So it's something to consider. And I'm going to wrap the video up, guys, because I really wanted this to be short and sweet, especially since my energy is like so low. Like, I'm super tired and I'm not putting forth my whole, y'all know how my normal vibe is or whatever. And I'm just like a little drained. But wow, 11:11. I'm sorry, you guys, but, you know, I love my synchronicities, my angel numbers, too. So, anyways, guys, I'm wrapping this video up. Be well, my loves, and I'll talk to you guys in the next video.